Both punches by LaMotta claim themselves.
This is explosive stuff here.
10 seconds left. Steel looks off. That's enough. That's enough.
From Sky Sports, it's Saturday Fight Night.
Wembley, the twin towers of the stadium, and just beside the arena. Together they've been the scene of some of the most famous fights in British boxing history. And tonight the arena stages a fight that few thought they'd ever see. Two world-class fighters meeting here inside this famous old stadium at the venue of legends, and how fitting that term is for the men who will meet in the ring. A very good evening to you from Wembley. We have two men here tonight trying to make up for all the lost years. They also happen to be two of the most extraordinary sportsmen that boxing has ever produced.
I believe I can fly.
He's back. Herol.
Herol Bummer Graham, perhaps the finest British fighter in the modern era, never to have won a world title. But how close he came, so often. From Sheffield, he went out to win the British, Commonwealth and European titles. And the middleweight put Brendan Ingalls' gym on the map long before Prince Nassim. Jim Callaghan was Prime Minister when Graham turned pro. 19 years later, Graham's still chasing his dream. He briefly retired, then he needed 5 years to regain his license. When his comeback did start, no one gave him a chance. But in one display against Chris Johnson, he confounded the experts who told him he was now wasting his time.
When Johnson was leaning back in the ropes, all his power was gone. Graham should have moved in with some shots there. Lovely punch.
Oh, there it is. He's put his leg buckled there. Graham's put it. It's all over. Graham's spotted that. What a victory in the eighth round.
Now Graham's back in a big fight against a man whose own comeback is even more remarkable. Vinny Pazienza broke his neck in a car crash in 1991. He was told his boxing days were over, but even while he was hospitalized, with his neck in a special brace, he started training again. It all happened only weeks after Pazienza had beaten Gilbert Delay to win the WBA World Light Middleweight title. An outstanding display which brought him his second world crown. Either side of the accident, Pazienza's been one of boxing's most colourful ever characters. Like Graham, he's defied convention to come back. Two men with a wealth of world-class experience, showmen who know how to sell a fight, and they meet head-to-head tonight. And with respect to the title belt on the line here tonight, this is really a story about two extraordinary boxing characters. Robin Reid, WBC World Super Middleweight Champion, joins myself and Barry McGuigan. What is it that is driving these two men? Why are they here tonight, Barry?
For Graham, he wants to win a world title. For Pazienza, he wants to defy all the people who doubt that he can do it again. And he wants to get at this guy, you know. So it's they both want to go for world titles. I mean, we know this is a junior title, but really, it's not the title, it's the fight, and it's the chance to go on to bigger things.
Do they feel they've been denied success that was due to them?
I think Graham very much feels that way. He was, as you said, one of the greatest fighters never to win a title. And it really is unfair on the guy after these many years that he hasn't really achieved it, because he was so talented and so much ability. It just didn't happen for the guy.
You must have been growing up watching him.
Yeah, that's right. He used to be, he paved the way for the likes of Prince Nassim. I remember, watching Herol Bummer Graham, and he was one of my favourites at the time. And I remember meeting him when I was amateur. He came to one of our amateur shows as a special guest. And I never thought, I'd be in this sort of, in my boat I am now, and he's chasing my title.
Indeed, maybe lining up a future opponent for Robin Reid. Well, the build-up to this fight has been something else, Barry, hasn't it, really?
Yeah.
Has it all been in the best possible taste?
Well,
it seemed to start reasonably good-naturedly.
Yeah, maybe not. I mean, it's all a bit of fun. This is show business at the end of the day.
Yes, but these were the early days, Barry. This is going back to last October, when it was all in good part. But they produced this fight poster, which has caused a lot of debate.
Yeah, I mean, I think that was the whole idea. It was to cause a big storm, and that in itself created a great deal of press, as we're looking at now.
Well, Vinny Pazienza told us on Thursday night he feels he's been greatly misquoted by the newspapers, that some of the things said about his private life do not...
He's a sensible, level-headed guy. I watched this here and I thought, this is a little bit over the top.
I think mother-in-laws up and down the country were a little shocked to see this.
This here was a little bit crass and uncouth and taken to extremes, but... However, it's all about pumping up the fight and creating interest, and there's a good crowd here tonight.
All right, the surprises continued at the weigh-in. Adam Smith saw what happened.
Herol Graham looked extremely relaxed, arriving half an hour early for last night's weigh-in. In fact, everyone was early, such is the great interest in this make-or-break fight. Everyone there, that is, except Pazienza. His entourage arrived for 5 o'clock without him. By 5:45, an impatient Graham decided enough was enough, telling the frustrated promoters he wanted to get weighed in so that he could get on with final preparations.
Herol Graham, the champion, is 11 stone, 11 and a half pounds.
And still, the Americans waited.
Vinny Pazienza is not here. He hasn't turned up. Is he scared, or is this a bit of psychology?
Well, maybe a bit of psychology, but it doesn't bother me. I've been in the game, boxing literally for over 24 years, and it doesn't bother me one bit. If he doesn't want to come, he doesn't want to come. That's up to him.
Will he be there on the night, Herol?
Let's hope so. You know, otherwise we're going to have a disappointed crowd here.
Graham then made a hasty exit, seeming totally unruffled as he shared a final word with the Pazienza team. But where was their fighter?
No one seems to know where he is at the moment. There's rumours flying around that he's locked himself in his hotel room and doesn't want to come out.
And what if he doesn't come out? Is the fight off?
Well, definitely. If he doesn't come here and make the weight within the next, is it 35 minutes, there is no championship fight.
The Queen may be here before him, but it will be here.
Will he be there tomorrow night?
He'll be here, don't worry.
He'll be there tomorrow night.
He'll be there.
Still no sign by 6:40. Prayers now for the fight to go ahead.
They say if you don't get here by 7 o'clock, they're going to cancel the fight. They're not fooling around, Ben. They're 5 minutes away. All right, champ.
And at 6:45, he finally arrived.
Vinny, is everything okay?
Sure, why not?
How come you're so late?
I'm always late for weigh-ins.
And no weight problems.
Vinny Pazienza is bang on the championship world toast on. We have a...
Vinny Pazienza, you finally turned up. What on earth was going on?
It's Christmas time. Traffic was crazy.
Do we believe that, Vinny?
You have to. It's a story I'm sticking with.
I think Mr. Pazienza is going to be less than delighted, Barry, when he hears the news that we have had from ringside tonight. The British board say they will fine him £3,000 for his almost no-show at that weigh-in.
That's $5,000, so he'll...
That hurts.
Oh, you're joking me. That's what this game's all about at this stage. Well, not all about, but a great deal of it's about money, and he'd be very upset about that. However, it smacks of weight problems. It suggests that he hasn't got his weight right and that he's, again, suffering from trouble with the weight. You know, he's come down, and he's a cool customer, and we believe that he's mucking around at the moment backstage. But that's the sort of thing he's at. He's good at that. There's a little bit of psychology involved in it, but I do think he's had trouble doing the weight.
Robin, one story to that he came on the show, you may have seen it on Thursday evening, and took that much water during an hour that he was in the studio and would not take any more because he was worried about his weight.
I mean, that does suggest that he's got weight problems. I mean, if he's turned up so late for the weigh-in, you don't know if he's had to, like, skip that weight off, you know, sweating it out and whatever to make the weight. But, I mean, I think it's very undisciplined and very unprofessional.
Yeah.
Whether it be psychological games or not, I don't know.
Well, good news anyway, for the fight night, he did leave in plenty of time. Made his way up from the West End. See, he's been staying in a hotel near Marble Arch and up to Wembley through that North Circular Road traffic in good time. That's his long-standing girlfriend, we understand.
That's a fight, I was mild silly.
Something he's been through so often. His 48th fight tonight, Pazienza.
Yeah, but this is just him, Paul. This is just Paz. He knows what he's doing. He's trying to drag it out and create as many problems as he can. He won't let the guys into the dressing room with him. But he's ready, don't get me wrong,
None of that will work with somebody like Bomber Graham,
no, absolutely not, you know, absolutely not. I mean, he's doing everything he can to upset everybody, but the one that he's least annoying is Graham.
I mean, how do you see it?
I mean, at the end of the day, I mean, we all like to get the psychological games that we're against our opponents and what have you. I mean, but there's one extreme to another, isn't there, you know? I mean, that's my views, I wouldn't go to these extremes. If you're that good at fighting, you're that confident in yourself, do you need to go to these extremes to get one over on your opponent?
No, if he wins here tonight, Frank Maloney won't be too keen to promote him again if he's behaving like that. But, you know, who knows what it's about?
Will Graham be worried about what Pazienza might be doing up the corridor right now?
I don't think so. As long as he steps through those ropes, that's all that matters. And even if he doesn't after the weigh-in, after having got ready, you know, he's ready for the fight. He's done his bit, and it's up to Pazienza to step through the ropes and, as I say, get it on with him.
Barry, his trainer here, Glyn Rhodes, they had a well-publicized falling out because Rhodes, as his friend said to him, forget this, you should go and do something else with your life.
Well,
but he proved Rhodes wrong last time.
He proved me wrong too, categorically, and you know, he really showed against a world-class opponent that he still has it. But I think Glenn, having looked at him in against sort of six-round, eight-round fighters, he didn't really perform then, but he wasn't up for it, he wasn't motivated for it. It had to be instilled with a bit of fear, like he was against Johnson, and then he performed. He's up for tonight. This is a great opportunity.
Well, last time out at Olympia back in the summertime, Barry, Johnson came to these shores as a highly rated new American prospect, or Canadian prospect.
Absolutely. I mean, I had watched him, and I thought he was very impressive, and I thought he was going to get rid of Graham, and yet, look what happened to him. He just took him apart. And that's the problem tonight. You see, if Pazienza falls into the same trap of being frustrated, and he's got that little irky-jerky, he's only 5'7", powerful, not a terrific puncher, I'm sure you'll agree, but he's got an irky-jerky style, he's fast, he's bringing the speed up with him. But if he gets frustrated, which Graham will endeavour to do, you switch from southpaw to orthodox and mess him around, turn him around, if he gets frustrated, he could lose the fight in the first four rounds.
How good was Pazienza before the accident?
Pazienza was a magnificent fighter, but always fighting below his natural weight and couldn't really do it. Then he jumped up here and, he beat Gilbert Delay for the light middleweight title. Nobody believed he could do it. He went from 135 pounds to 154, and he beat the guy all over the place. He was fantastic, remarkable guy and a remarkable athlete. And it's his tenacity that is main asset. He's not a terrific puncher, he's not a terrific boxer, he does everything very well, but he's so determined.
Robin, how much respect do you have for him for the problems he's overcome?
Oh yeah, great respect. I mean, like I said, seeing on Thursday, you know, he was fighting for, you know, they said he never fights again. At the end of the day, he's, you know, got in his mind that he is going to fight again, and proving people wrong, you know, when he's out there to prove a point again that, you know, not only is he going to there to fight again, he wants to go on and win world titles.
I think his biggest problem is, Robin, it's not his age. 34 is not old for fighters nowadays. I think the fact that he's been out for 16 months, and if he were coming back against a conventional fighter, that may be okay, but he's coming back against somebody who is so unconventional, difficult to hit, and unorthodox, as you say, he's going to have real problems.
Is it difficult to get rid of the rust when, as you say, he has not been in a fight apart from his gym work over the last 12 months?
No, there's nothing like ring sharpness. You can spar as much as you like in the gym. I'm sure Robin will agree. But when you get into the ring, that's when you get your competition sharpness. And you can't get it by sparring and boxing in the gymnasium.
And then especially, you know, coming in against someone like Bill McGraham, who is as elusive as he is as well.
Yeah.
You know,
That's the point I make. However, don't ever write him off. This guy's got it.
Thanks for now to Robin Reid and to Barry McGuigan, our commentary team at ringside tonight. Glenn McCrory and Ian Dark, and we'll hear from them both after our master of ceremonies for this one, the American Mark Biro.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the main event of the evening. Introducing, making his way to the ring, from the States he comes, the challenger, Vinny Pazienza.
Here's Vinny Pazienza, the flamboyant, dynamic, entertaining fighter with the macho man image. The man who won world championships at two weights and then came back from a car crash that broke his neck to beat men like Lloyd Hunnigan and Roberto Duran twice. He calls himself the Pazmanian Devil. He's one of the most charismatic fighters in the world. But the question is really, is the old fire and desire still there, 10 days short of his 35th birthday? And what do we make of all these antics with him nearly 2 hours late for the weigh-in? Does he have real problem at the weight?
Well, I think that's a big question. In my belief, he has got big problems with the weigh-in. I think he was very, very tight. And his delay at the weigh-in was down to him making weight. And I think, you know, it was that tight for him. You've got to think now, he looked very, very powerful. He's going to put an awful lot of weight on. He's going to be a big, strong man. But look, Graham's got to use his reflexes, his speed. Tony Glyn Rhodes doesn't know. He said, this guy is very, very tough. They're expecting a tough fight. They know he's got a good chin, so they're going to go out there and they're going to try and box him, frustrate him, and box him some more.
Remarkable man, Vinny Pazienza.
And now, ladies and
still fighting. The Herol Graham story that seems to have been running longer than the mousetrap. It really would be one of the most incredible happenings in boxing if he was to come back after a four-year retirement at the age of 38, beat somebody like Vinny Pazienza, and then go on to win the world title that he surely deserved first time around. He's so quick and slippery and skillful that he can be a delight to watch. The Sheffield boxing maverick, who seemed to have been reborn amazingly in his last fight, Herol, and I'm still going to use his old nickname, not the new one, Bomber Graham.
Well, we've got to wonder, how much has he really got left? Was the Chris Johnson, was that just a fluke? Did Chris Johnson make him look better? Because up to that point, he hadn't looked good. He'd struggled. Glyn Rhodes even washed his hands of him. But it was a remarkable win against Chris Johnson. And is he back? Is he reborn?
Yes, he almost looked like the revisit of a ghost from his own past on that occasion. Here's the tale of the tape for this fascinating fight, which has got a lot more about it, I think, than a lot of world championship fights. Graham, 38. Pazienza, 34. They're relics from the 15-round days. Graham, big height and reach advantages could be very significant. Graham, well inside the 12-stone limit. Pazienza, tight at him. Graham's been going for 19 years and has had 52 fights. Pazienza for 14 and a half years and has had 47. Look how many rounds they've boxed. What's that? Nearly 700 between them. Average per fight, about 6. Knockout percentage, not much in it, really. Pazienza probably slightly the sharper puncher, but not by much. Graham's punching's often underestimated. There's the rules. There is a mandatory 8. There's no standing 8. No 3 knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. The bell will save a fallen fighter only in the last round. It's the WBC International Super Middleweight title they're fighting for here, but for the winner, there will surely be a World Championship shot. We have the chemistry for a great fight here.
Tonight's bouts are under the auspices of the British Boxing Board of Control, President and Chairman Leonard Reed, General Secretary John Morris. Ladies and gentlemen, this is London, and from Wembley Arena, Arthur Palullo's Banner Promotions, in association with Frank Maloney for Panix Promotions, Sky Sport, USA Tuesday Night Fights, and Budweiser, the undisputed, undefeated king of beers, this Bud's for You presents Main Event, 12 rounds for the WBC International Super Middleweight Championship. Ring officials assigned by the World Boxing Council, President Jose Suleiman, and the attending supervisor is Mauro Betti. Your judges at ringside are, from Morristown, New Jersey, Aníbal Miramontes. From Brussels, Belgium, Bob Legiste. And from Northampton, England, John Payne. Your referee for this contest, from Dallas, Texas, Lawrence Cole. Introducing now the principals first, in the blue corner to my left, wearing the red and white trunks, weighing in at 12 stone even, or 168 pounds. In 47 contests, his professional record reads 41 victories, 6 defeats. He has 28 wins coming by way of knockout. He hails from Providence, Rhode Island. In 52 contests.
So we're all set to go here at Wembley Arena. And incidentally, in the corner tonight for Pazienza will be Kevin Rooney, Mike Tyson's old trainer. And a lot of people say that Tyson was never the same once Rooney left him. What has he done for Pazienza here? Pazienza is a real raging bull, exciting kind of style. And watch for the slick, speedy boxing of Graham. And just look at the difference in size between them. Graham, 4 inches taller. Pazienza was saying in the build-up to the fight that he thought Graham might make him look stupid at times, but he said, in the end, I will nail him. Believe it, Graham will be knocked out. In his whole career, Herol Graham has only been stopped a couple of times in over 50 fights.
And at his best, Herol Graham was almost impossible to hit, very good defensively. But at his age now, has he still got the reflexes?
Yes, those are often the first things that go in a fighter, the speed and the reflexes. But against Chris Johnson last time, miraculously, he seemed to have them back. Is that a one-off, as you were saying, Glenn, or can he do it all over again here? He may need to against a pressure fighter like Pazienza. Pazienza has been out of the ring for 16 months since a very good win over Dana Rosenblatt, who was unbeaten before that. Pazienza nailed him with a big right hand in the fourth round and got fined for knocking the referee over in the process that night. In many ways, they're maverick personalities of a different kind, these two, aren't they?
They really are. Pazienza's got to try and deal with the style of Graham. And Graham landed with a good long left-hand shot. It's a very unorthodox style that Graham has.
American referee with a word of caution for Graham. He's looking to keep it at range, predictably enough, behind his slippery southpaw style. Pazienza can't reach him so far, and Graham just occasionally picking him off on the way in.
Pazienza finding it very difficult. He's got to try and cut the ring off. He's got to try and get to Graham.
Did reach him with the right hand to the body there. Sometimes Graham's own punch power has been underestimated down the years. Herol would have won the first round, I think. Welcome back to Wembley Arena, one of the most famous boxing venues in Britain. Vinny Pazienza with Kevin Rooney in his corner, one of the most famous trainers in the world through his association with Mike Tyson.
Second out, round two.
Quiet opening round. Something of a phony war. Here's the second, Pazienza in the white trunks and Sheffield's Herol Graham in the tartan. Newly married Graham, it says that he's settled down a good deal. He's had a lot of his big fights in his past. He had a lot of domestic problems with relationships that had messed up his mind. Now he's very happy and settled and really believes he can have a successful second career. But tonight really is a defining night in that second career.
Pazienza has to start to work the body. It's very difficult to get to Graham's head. He moves it very well, but the body's much more difficult to move. So Pazienza would do well to just direct his punches to the body for the time being. Just try and slow Graham down.
Graham is out of reach with his own jab for a lot of the time here. caught by the right hand there, and I just wonder whether the old Herol Graham that we all remember in the 80s would have taken that shot. Graham will look to bring that left hand into play as well.
Graham using the southpaw jab well there. He's got to use his reach, his height advantage. Keep it at long range. Don't let Pazienza get close to him.
Amazing to think that when Graham was coming through in Brendan Ingalls' gym, Nassim Hamed was a little boy of 7 years, 8 years of age, just hanging around unnoticed in the gym, idolising Herol. Amazing that they're still both fighting and topping big bills this December. How soon before Pazienza really starts to gamble? He's being frustrated by Graham at the moment, but as I was saying, he kind of knew this would happen.
Yes, Graham is doing the right thing. He's just trying to pick him off from long range. He's bringing the left hand into effect very well. That's a good straight punch, and he's managing to catch Pazienza, who at times is getting a little square on, trying to combat the southpaw stance.
Still has that capacity, Graham, to bring in punches from unexpected angles when people do try to close the range on him. Two rounds gone. I've given them both to Herol Graham. And now here's the record that has been going on over a period of 19 years. Look at that. He was an ABA middleweight champion right in this very arena in 1978. It's incredible, isn't it? He was in 15 rounders. I think he won his first British title against Pat Thomas in 1981. I'm ashamed to say I remember those days.
1990, when he lost the second world title bid to Julian Jackson, when we thought after that it would all be over. It was a very dramatic knockout, one we thought we'd never see him in the ring this late.
I tell you what, that was amazing. I was there in the south of Spain that night. He absolutely made Julian Jackson look stupid for 3.5 rounds. He made him look like a novice, and then it was one punch and lights out and over.
And that very much is what can happen in boxing. I think Herol will remember that and knows that it can always happen.
He just got careless that night. It was stupid, really. He should have been world champion, because Jackson was so badly cut there, we would have been over in another round anyway. Just had to stay out of trouble and didn't. Third round here. Graham, by the way, being watched tonight by another Sheffield boxing hero I've seen at ringside. Not boxing hero, sporting hero, Sebastian Coe. Sometimes it seems in Herol's fights he's run almost as far as Coe.
Herol's got to try and frustrate Pazienza. He's got to make him box his fight and be looking for Graham.
He's not really having to do too much dancing, even, Graham, is he? At the moment, he can conserve his legs almost if it's like this.
Pazienza rushing in, swinging wildly, but he's not connecting with these punches. Graham trying to keep the center of the ring, do everything from there, and that will reserve his energy somewhat.
Yes, it may be hard for him to sustain the tactics over 12 rounds. Frustrated look on the face of Pazienza, world champion at lightweight in 1987 and then at light middle in 1991. He failed three times in attempts for the light welterweight crown. And was beaten by Roy Jones when he went for the IBF super middleweight title. No shame in that, of course. Jones, one of the best fighters of the modern era.
Pazienza just using the ropes there to give himself a little bit of leverage and then get out of that corner, pushing himself off the rope, showing his experience in doing that.
Pazienza is finding what so many fighters before have found, that it is very, very difficult to hit Herol Graham.
Very little scoring from either one in this round. Very negative round, both missing a lot.
Reflexes still good enough from Graham to make Pazienza miss embarrassingly. It must be infuriating to fight Herol Graham. I remember Tony Simpson once famously describing him as a glorified limbo dancer.
Just a reminder about next Saturday fight night action. A week tonight, we're in Sheffield. Ryan Rhodes against Otis Grant for the WBO World Middleweight title. Next Saturday, 9:30.
Sky Sports One.
Herol Graham against Vinny Pazienza in the ring now at Wembley. And at ringside, Seb Coe watching another former Sheffield sporting hero. Back to Glenn and Ian.
And I saw Davy Jones, the old lead singer of the Monkees, there as well. I think they'd stopped having hits by the time Herol made his debut. Somebody will correct me, please don't write in. Tartan trunks of Graham, and Pazienza is finding this as frustrating a night as he kind of thought it would be. So far, anyway.
Isn't that give the third round as an even round? Because Graham is in a little danger. He's not working himself. It's okay making Pazienza miss, frustrating him, but he's got to continue working. He's got to build up the points. And he's got to do that with scoring punches with a jab and bring the left hand into play.
Pazienza looking to up the tempo. He'll be wanting to cut Graham off on the corners and start slowing him down with some body punches. Graham himself is boxing very conservatively, though, so far. Fairly respectful of Pazienza's reputation. Could be plenty of ring rust there as well for Pazienza. Among his other problems, he's been out of the ring for 16 months. He says he's worked very hard and he's been giving his sparring partners a tough time in training, but then fighters do say those kind of things at press conferences 3 days before the fight.
Pazienza lunging forward there, having to really reach to try and get to Graham. He's still at times going for Graham's head, and he'd be better suited going for the body. It's much more difficult to move that.
He's trying to make Graham come to him a little more, that, hence the dance around the ring ropes just now. Pazienza looking for the counter. I think he knows he has to try something different to break up the pattern here. I think Graham thinks that all the time the fight is out here, he'll be the boss.
And still just trying to pepper Pazienza with that jab.
Pazienza getting a little closer there. I'd like to see Graham himself do a little more, or is this so far so good, do you think?
Well, I think it's early stages, but Graham maybe just trying to play a few mind games, just frustrate Pazienza. And I think to that point it'll be working, but he's still got to remember he's got to pick up the points. And Pazienza is starting to get that little bit closer, starting to score with those right hands.
There's a slightly concerned look on Graham's face as Pazienza did find him with the right hand. Welcome back to the Wembley Arena. Punches landed so far, not too many. 36 by Graham and only 13 by Pazienza. Only a 14% success rate. That's one of the lowest we've ever seen, I think, on the computer. That's testimony to the elusiveness of Herol Graham. Graham, who says he hit rock bottom financially when he had to go into retirement. He lost his jewellery business. He said he lost a lot of friends as well, lost some self-esteem. Now he tries to get it back the best way he knows how. And Pazienza, who's a millionaire.
And that's how I have it. I'm not giving a great deal to Pazienza, just giving him a share of the third round. But Graham still can't forget, he's got to be busy himself. He can't just rely on picking with the jabs.
Starting to bring the left hand into play. You may wish to see a bit more of that from Graham. He gets more busy at the start of this round. Some blood from the mouth and nose by the look of it of Pazienza. So one of those punches has caused some damage.
Still there's not a great deal of work from either. Lots of pausing. They're trying to find ways in. Pazienza a little frustrated, doesn't know how to get in past that jab.
Made to miss by a mile by Graham. Sometimes it seems you couldn't hit him with a box of confetti. Crowd beginning to get behind Graham. He's a popular figure, much more popular, I think, now than he was when he first started out. People thought he was a bit of a bore, to be quite honest with you, in his early career. They knew he was talented. He's starting to do some more impressive work here.
Yes, he's starting to catch Pazienza around the face. Just a few little bumps and scratches around the face of Pazienza. So maybe Graham can start to bang him up from long range.
Every so often, Pazienza tries a few verbals. Graham is really a master craftsman and technician. Knows what he's doing in there. Doesn't mean he's going to win. Pazienza frustrated. He still has a lot of the speed. Maybe it's not the speed he had when he was 25. But he's fast, all right, and that's Graham's round. Pazienza goes back to the wrong corner. Was he that confused? Surely not.
Well, he's having to go in a few different corners during this fight because he's having to chase Graham long and hard. There's Kevin Rooney, who was very famous with Mike Tyson, a great partnership they were. He really worked Tyson so well.
It all ended very acrimoniously, of course, which is why he's not there anymore.
Graham showing good skills in defense here, just making a miss, turning to the side, then coming back with counters. And again, Pazienza rushing forward, trying to find a big hook, and Graham just making a miss by the slightest amount and swerving out of the way. Good defensive skills from Graham.
I think why Pazienza went to Graham's corner at the end of the round was that Graham's trainer, Glyn Rhodes, was taunting him. I think there was a little exchange there. Sixth round.
Glyn Rhodes just shouting things still at Pazienza. You don't look so tough. Come on, Vinny.
How much does Pazienza still want this with so much money in the bank and with a movie career on the go as well? It would be in the second half of the fight if his game plan was going to work, but he would start to get to Graham. Let's see if that happens in the next few rounds.
That was probably the best Pazienza punch so far, that long right hand, but he's having to reach so far to try and connect to Graham.
Fighters do go on longer these days. George Foreman winning a world heavyweight championship beyond the age of 40 is second. There's Pazienza landing with the right again.
Trying to get close, trying to threaten almost, but still not able to get close enough to land a punch.
Yes. The ends are getting with a right hand there. And a very good right cross from Graham there. That was a reminder to Pazienza that on the way in, there could be problems for him. A lot of these jabs by Graham might not be scoring punches. They're pitter-pat rangefinders, a lot of them.
Yes, he's just trying to take the eye for straight Pazienza. Pazienza landed with some more solid punches in this round. He's getting a little bit closer. He's got to try and put more together if he wants to connect and hurt Graham. He's just not quite getting close enough.
Graham in control, but leading. But Vinny Pazienza, with his style, is the kind of fighter who might yet prove dangerous and who could yet turn this around. Smart counters from Graham. Here's Pazienza really going for broke. This is bull in a china shop stuff from Pazienza. He decided then that he'd be quite happy to walk through a few just to get to Graham. He's trying to wear him down now.
Ooh, better from Pazienza now. He's getting closer, starting to land with punches.
And he still wants to swap words with the Graham corner. This is hotting up all the time. Let's go to Barry McGuigan and see how he's reading it.
Yeah, Ian, I've always felt that the fight wasn't going to really liven up until the second half. It just has unfolded the way I thought it was going to unfold. Graham was frustrated and got out into a nice, comfortable lead at this stage. But it's the first round where Pazienza has actually started to get to him, started to hit him with punches, and I really feel that now is when the fight will start to liven up. And really, Pazienza has a lot of ground to make up, and this is when it will become exciting. I feel it will really start to hot up now over the next couple of rounds.
Thank you, Barry. Marked up around the face, Pazienza. He's been through a few ring wars in his time. You won't worry about that.
10 seconds. Go, Kevin. But definitely getting closer, Pazienza, starting to land with some blows now. Caught with a nice little counter from Graham on the way in. But I think Pazienza will have gotten more confidence from that round, thinking he can get closer to him.
Into the second half of the fight. Remember, it's the junior world title, WBC International Super Middleweight Championship they're fighting for.
And that's how I've got it. I've still got Graham a good lead at this stage.
Graham himself has boxed well within himself. Cool. Iceman type tactics from him, and look at that smart counter punching from him. Beautiful right uppercut, just lent away, found the right uppercut through the gap. As he enters though, looks with the right hand. He's gambling more, Pazienza, now, isn't he?
Well, I think he feels he has to. He's not going to be able to outbox Graham. He's got to get close. He's got to rough him up, get him out of his stride. Otherwise, he's just going to be outboxed at long range.
There's a real danger for him coming in, though, and gambling like that, that Graham nails him with a big counter shot. Like those punches there. Pazienza tried to get close, and boof boof, right left from Graham.
Well, at this point the concentration of Graham is still very good, keeping center ring, boxing as he wants to. He's just got to keep that concentration, can't have any wavers in that whatsoever.
Pazienza looks to wear his opponents down usually, but he finds that hard if he can't land the shots.
Seems to be more blood around the face of Pazienza. I'm not sure if it's off the nose, but he's certainly starting to mark up.
Graham almost seems to be doing this in second gear, doesn't he, at the moment? Oh, he got hit with the right hand there. Caught on the ropes. This is where Pazienza wants to be, isn't it, Glenn?
Sorry, and yes, now he's getting to him. This is better when he can start to land with two punches. It's better for Pazienza.
And the left hand catching Graham there right at the end of the rubber. Graham wants to fight back. The bell went in the middle of all that. Pazienza wants to carry on. They didn't hear the bell, I don't think. And Pazienza felt there that he got to Graham right at the end of the round, although Herol did come back with two good counter shots. Well,
yes, it's really starting to liven up now. Pazienza wanted to go after the bell. Graham caught him just at the break, and he was very angry by that. But I think Pazienza was starting to get to Graham. I think he maybe hurt him with one good shot in the corner, and the bell went just at that point. But it was good work from Pazienza. Graham still keeping cool under pressure. But Pazienza, just the feeling he's getting that much closer.
Corners, 10 seconds.
Yes, that left hand, actually looking at it again, seemed to be more of a slap. It wasn't such a good punch as it looked first time up. Graham, who's beaten people like Hunter Clay, Lindell Holmes, Sandaline Williams, Ayab Kalouli, Mark Kaler, and on his comeback, Chris Johnson, said 17 championship fights. Glenn scorecard with Graham in a two-round lead. I have it a little wider. Eighth round. Is this Pazienza territory in the fight? Judges, by the way, are from USA, Belgium, and England's John Keane. Pazienza being made to miss. And now he wants to showboat, and he's inviting Graham in because he wants to counterpunch him. Graham's having none of that, been around too long.
Yes, Graham just trying to keep at his fight. He knows what he's got to do. He can't afford to go looking for Pazienza. He's just got to let Pazienza chase him, do what he does best.
A few mind games in there going on. Some people wondered whether Pazienza, who brought his fiancée across, was just having a nice paid holiday in London. But I don't think that's really in his fighting makeup. I think he's got too much pride for that.
Yes, I don't think that's his nature. He's a fighter through and through. Anybody who can come back from horrific injuries to his neck and spine, told he'd never walk again, never mind box, and then to be here in a fight, has got tremendous character.
Still just pitter-patter jabs, really, from Graham.
Well, I think that's the danger, Ian, that there's nothing coming back from Graham. The defensive work's very, very good, but they're not real scoring punches. The patter jabs, he's just fainting with those, trying to make Pazienza do something. He's got to keep scoring himself.
Yes, maybe Graham needs a few more solid shots to take the eye of the judges, particularly maybe the American, who, well, they tend to score on aggression over there. And somebody knocked an advertising warning into the ring, and Graham nearly fell over that. Graham fight at a faster pace now, Pazienza, but how much is he really landing? Not at all, is he?
Yes, he's getting through with something into the body. You've got to look what Graham's doing as well. And you know, they're not really scoring punches. Difficult, a difficult round. Graham needs to do more.
Graham's landed a lot more punches so far. A lot of them, though, have just been kind of range-finding jabs rather than really meaty shots. Pazienza has been on the chase all the time, but he's found it hard to land, you know.
Yes, there wasn't a lot of scoring punches from either man in the last round.
Too much grease, I think, around the eyes of Pazienza. Referee from Dallas, Lawrence Cole, wants that wiped away. Pazienza camp were not altogether happy with the choice of referee, simply on the grounds they said that they'd never heard of him. Neither had we, but he's doing okay, I think.
Two good punches from Graham there. Reflexes were good. I think if they're putting lots of grease around the face of Pazienza, they're obviously worried that the skin might start to open up and cuts could become a problem.
Well, these jabs, whatever their quality, are obviously doing some damage. Kind of left hand with a hint of the inside of the glove from Pazienza. Pazienza, who's got wins over people like Melvin Paul, Greg Haugen, Gilbert Delay, former world champion on his record, Louis Santana, Lloyd Hunnigan, a faded Lloyd Hunnigan, Dan Sherry, the old Eubank foe, Robbie Sims, Roberto Duran twice. He's beaten all of those, Pazienza. So that's the kind of pedigree you're talking about with this man. And as you're seeing again here, Herol Graham has the capacity to make even very talented name fighters look fairly wild and ordinary.
But again, he's not doing a great deal. Lots of just picking with that jab, just waving it about and just trying to place it in the face, but not scoring shots and not enough to keep Pazienza off him.
Just like to see Graham throw that jab with something more of a ramrod quality about it. It must drive you mad fighting this fella.
I think it would be one of the hardest things for a fighter to do. He's very difficult, very good at what he does, and he makes you make mistakes and then counters for those mistakes.
The damage by the right eye of Pazienza is getting worse. It's quite a mess now. Nothing you'd stop the fight for, but it will be a cause of some concern, I would think, to the corner. Even as they work in close, Pazienza not really able to catch Graham. Oh, he did then with the right hand. Now, is Graham hurt by that? Is that a breakthrough moment for Pazienza? Just looking a shade off balance. He got in there at the end of the round. Graham's okay. And you'd think that this was a real grudge fight between the two of them, the way they're carrying on there after the bell. But in the build-up, Pazienza was saying how much he liked Herol Graham. He said he's a classy guy with a good sense of humour, a lot of fun. Doesn't mean to say I'm not going to knock him out.
This is better for Pazienza. He's getting closer. He caught Graham with some good punches in that round. He's still not being able to work the way he wants. He wants to trap Graham and get his hands free and work. And not a great deal of clean work in that little exchange. But Graham, for me, just too much picking with it. There's the good right hand. That will have took the eye. Graham just picking with the jab too much.
10 seconds. Yes, he was on the run at the end of the round there, Graham. Now, that was the last thing the judges will have remembered. Look at that on jab so far. 67-4 for Herol Graham.
But how many of those jabs will have the judges have scored, because there's so very little in them. Are they scoring shots?
I just wonder whether there might be a controversy here. It depends on what you're giving weight to. Pazienza is the aggressor and gets him with another right hand and some body shots in. It's early in the round this time. Now Graham will have to do some fighting here, and this will test maybe how much fighting hard and desire he's got left. Pazienza having his best start to the round, and these are the most dangerous moments in the fight yet for Graham.
Pazienza with a hand on the rope there, trying to pull, get some extra leverage in and some power. The referee should have seen that and stopped him from doing that, but I think the Pazienza camp are now starting to see a lot more shout. They're getting a little more excited that Pazienza is starting to get to Graham.
Pazienza gets in with the left hand, and it may be getting to the stage where Graham, to some extent, has to meet fire with fire here. He has to up his own work rate, Graham. Otherwise, there's a danger that the judges will score all these late rounds for Pazienza on his aggression.
Yes. Graham can't afford to wait. He can't afford just to look to counter at this stage. He's got to start taking the eye. He's got to start doing more. You need to see that left hand come into play. That was better from Graham.
Quite circumspect, Graham. He doesn't want to get too close. Just measuring Pazienza for size. Pazienza just pulled off his own assault for a moment. Maybe he's got a bit tired after chasing Graham around. And remember, too, suspicions that Pazienza may be tight at the weight. And if he is, maybe that will be a factor later on. There's another right hand crashing home, though, from the American. Pazienza's getting there now, and he looked unsteady on his legs, Graham, there. And the right hand. Desperate moments now for Graham. This has changed, and changed quite dramatically. Graham is on the run. Pazienza's shouting at him, talking to him. This wild, flamboyant American fighter who was frustrated for so long here looks now as if the victory could yet be his. Pazienza will not go back to his corner. He wants to carry on the argument.
He's enjoying it now. This is the sort of fight he wants. Now he's getting to Graham. There's nothing coming back. Graham's having to take heavy punches. Pazienza's, you know, he's full of it now. He's chased Graham for so long. He's finally getting there. He's getting close, starting to land with good punches. And you just start to feel that maybe he's starting to break through the defences. You know, a few years ago, or several years ago, we never used to see Graham getting hit this much. His reflexes were always very good. Now he's starting to get hit with punches.
Well, they say that the last thing a fighter loses is his punch. The first thing he loses is the speed and the reflexes. And his defense was always based on speed and reflexes. Pazienza has just shouted to the American TV people, "I'm going to knock him out." He might be right. Here's the 11th round. The tide has turned here now.
Yes, it has turned. Now, Mike scorecard, Pazienza's work in the last few rounds has good brought it back to level pegging.
Maybe a question of how many of the early rounds, which were relatively uneventful, were given to Graham when Pazienza could hardly land, and Graham was just keeping him at range, but not doing that much himself either. Graham needs a comeback round here. How much did that last round take away from him? Pazienza breathing heavily himself, having to dig pretty deep.
Well, it's at this point that Graham needs a big round.
Otherwise, he could be knocked back into retirement, and it really will be the end of the long, long story. There aren't too many places to go for the loser here.
Ben Graham just waiting a bit too long. He needs to do more.
Graham now possibly needs to abandon his natural style and really go for it. Who knows how the judges are scoring it? It's still there to be won, isn't it?
Yes, very much so. On my scorecard, it's level. And I think, again, Graham stumbles back. It wasn't a good punch, but it may have just have took the judge's eyes.
I think he was off balance more than anything.
Yes, I think he was. He just stumbled
over
backwards.
His own feet, I think.
But it all at this part plays a psychological part. And Pazienza can be just spurred on for more work because of something like that.
Pazienza has done less in this round. Graham hasn't done badly because he looked at times in that last round as if he was on the brink of defeat.
And this is a much quieter round from both. For me, Graham needs to step it up. He needs to do more work.
Just seems to be stuck in one gear, though, Graham. I think we've seen tonight that he never can be the fighter he was before.
Scoring with a good quick left hook, which brought applause from the crowd.
Graham's winning this round at the moment. At the moment. Pazienza, you can be sure, will look for a late finish, but it's too late. That's Graham's got that one, so this could be on a knife edge on the cards, you know. Could be.
Well, it's very, very close for me. I think Graham just did a little better in the last round. He got off with a few punches. He got some nice clean ones. It was quiet at the opening, but there's a good left hook. Pazienza, I think, was tired after his big outburst in the previous round. And he just took his foot off the gas, where really, I think he needed at that stage to do a lot more and press home his advantage when he had Graham, you know, in a little bit of trouble and rocking around the ring.
Well, there may well be a world title fight for the winner. I think how they scored the early rounds here may be crucial.
Yes, we're just giving Graham that, the 11th. Just puts him one pointer ahead. It's still very close.
12th and last round, they touch gloves. These two have got to know each other fairly well through the sometimes controversial publicity that's preceded the fight.
Well, Graham's got to be busy. He's got to start using this jab for the left-handed, because Pazienza is going to try and come on strong in the last round.
Graham has to match him. Rather a clubbing kind of left hand with the inside of the glove from Pazienza. Pazienza would look for the big finish. Graham, as ever, on his bike. Graham got himself cleverly out of that corner. Well, he got home with the left hook that time, Pazienza. Solid looking shot. Maybe the winner of this last round will win the fight itself. It could be that close.
Yes, it really could be. There's very little in it. Graham's got to try and do more. He can't. He's got Pazienza in the corner. He should be letting the punches go now. It looked good.
He did catch him there with a left hand and another one too. Pazienza's been very tired looking in the last couple of rounds. He came on with a big effort from about the 7th to the 10th, but I think that took something away from him. And Graham, if anything, has just re-established a kind of control in the last couple of rounds. And has that been enough for him? Who knows?
There's a kind of control, but you would like him at this point to do more, to push home any advantage that he might feel he has.
It didn't really land that right hand. Well, the comeback plans of both these fighters depend really on what you're watching now. Pazienza made to miss again by Graham. How many of those southpaw jabs has he thrown tonight? Another left hand. Pazienza getting caught, leaving himself open.
This is a good last round. They're both putting an awful lot into it. They're both landing with good punches. Graham got through with a good left hook there.
He's landed a few of those in this round, and I think Graham has done the better work in this last round, up to now anyway. There goes the bell to end it. Graham thinks he's won it. He may well have done. He's busted up around the right eye now. Pazienza, as the fight ended. Bad damage, and Graham, who dominated the first half of the fight, had a sticky period, looked as if he was on the brink of defeat in the 10th. May, we don't know, have just done enough in the last couple to last him. Certainly the corner seemed very, very confident, didn't they?
Yes, they did, and I think Graham seemed very confident himself. I think he felt that he'd done it. Pazienza, bad damage to the right eye at the end of the fight. He tried everything, but it just looked as if he was tiring.
Once again for these two fighters,
Graham's punching the air. He clearly feels that he's outboxed Pazienza. The two of them embrace. Pazienza certainly bearing the scars of battle. But you never like to second-guess the judges. I think Graham's won myself. I would have him as the winner, wouldn't you, Glenn?
Yes, I would. That's how I have it. 116 to 114. Two rounds I give Graham to win by. But it was there was a lot of rounds early on and in the middle where were difficult to score. You know, they were very close. It's how you interpreted what was going on. Graham wasn't putting a lot of power into his punches. And also, American just goes for aggression. You know, will he have given a lot to Pazienza because of that?
There's a British judge as well, John Keane. The other one is Bob Logist from Belgium, an experienced official. Now, if Graham has won this, he'll be looking, I'm sure, for a world title fight. He thinks that people like Reed and Calzaghe would try to avoid him. He is a frustrating company customer. He's not the kind of guy you'd really choose to get into the ring with. Now, who has won this? They're collating the scorecards. Graham seems confident. Pazienza didn't raise his arms at the end.
I got it wrong. I understand.
That's the belt they're fighting for. It's a comparatively junior belt, this WBC international title, but it could be the passport to something much bigger. Now, here we go. Let's join our MC. Let's hear how it's gone.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision. Judge Aníbal Miramontes scores it 116-113. Judge Bob Logis scores it 118-113. And Judge John Keane scores it 117-112 to the winner and WBC International Super Middleweight Champion, Herol Graham!
What a win for Herol Graham! The incredible comeback story continues. He had a dodgy moment in the 10th round, but he's done it again. And at the age of 38, he is hunting down the world title that eluded him the first time around. The judges scoring it by three rounds, five rounds, twice. Wider than we thought, Glenn.
And it's a great story. He'll be very pleased. And you know, hopefully he'll get his chance to be back in the world stage and finally get a world title that he's wanted for so many years.
After the break, we shall be talking to Herol Bomber Graham. Join us then.
Robin Reed defending his WBC World Super Middleweight title against Sugar Boy Malinga, plus Prince Nassim fighting in New York the same night. It's all part of a special pay-per-view presentation on Sky Box Office. For more information, 0990-800-888. Here now, in just a few moments, Pat Mullings against Havika Hadrian for the International Super Bantamweight title. But first, we've seen a thriller and a fantastic boxing story unfolding before our eyes. Herol Bomber Graham still very much in business. Here he is talking to Ian Dark.
Still the champion. Your thoughts on that performance and that win?
It was a hard fight. Vinny Pazienza is a tough guy. And if you're going to beat him, you've got to beat him inside as well as outside. I beat him mainly on running away, but that's a part of boxing, I'm afraid. And like, it was my best ammunition, is moving, jabbing. That's what I could do, that's what I did, and that's won me the fight.
You had a very dodgy moment in the 10th round. We thought maybe there you were going to be on the verge of defeat. What were you thinking then?
I was thinking, oh, shit. But no, really, I just lost my footing, really. And I just got caught by a shot. So I had to compose myself and get back into the game.
What were you thinking the judges' scorecards were saying there? Because sometimes fights like that can be sort of hard to score and ending sort of controversial decisions.
Well, judging it myself, I thought it was in my hands. It's a situation that if I lost more than three rounds, when I know I didn't, then I'd lost the fight probably. But I thought I won quite comfortably. Although it was a hard fight, it kept me going all the time. And congratulations to Vinny Pazienza as well.
Where does the Herol Graham story go from here? I mean, I guess you must be looking for one of the world champions now. Robin Reed, Joe Calzaghe, that kind of thing.
Look, I don't care who it is. Bring on the champion. I'll fight the champion and I'll beat the champion. But let's not talk about where we're going to fight and who we're going to fight. Then it's about money. Just bring on Robin Reed, anybody, honestly. And I'll fight anybody anywhere in their own backyard if they want it to be. But I think they're going to run scared of me.
Thanks a lot, Herol. Well done tonight.
Oh, yes, indeed. Robin Reed with Barry McGuigan and myself tonight. What did you make of it?
I thought he fought a very cagey fight. A couple of in the early rounds, a couple of tight rounds, I thought. Second part of the fight, he looked like he might have just, like, you know, he was going to let Pazienza get to him, which he did do. And then I think the last two rounds pulled it out the bag for him.
Barry?
I didn't think, first of all, the judging reflected how close the fight was. I mean, it's a subjective thing, you know, deciding who wins rounds and so on. However, I thought Pazienza put up a much more credible performance than the judges gave him credit for. However, Graham deserved to win the fight, and he's never had a break in his life, and I'm delighted for him.
Absolutely. Never had a good break, you mean?
A good break. It's, you know, I hope he gets a world title fight. I hope we can get it together with this guy. He may be a bit too late for him. He looked very vulnerable there in the later rounds, but it couldn't happen to a nicer guy. I hope he gets a chance to earn big money.